everyone. In this video, I will explain you how to represent racial numbers on the number line. Children, you have learned to represent natural numbers, whole numbers and integers in the previous classes. Let us recall first of all to represent integers on a number line. We draw a line and mark a point O corresponding to 0 on it. Starting from the 0, we mark points at equal distances on the right side as well as on the left side. On the right side, the positive numbers will come and on the left side, negative numbers will come. On the left side of 0, these are negative numbers, or we can say these are negative integers, and this side, on the right side of 0, positive numbers are there, and 0 is neither positive nor negative. This we have learned in class 6, and in the 7th class we have learned racial numbers also. In the same manner, now we shall now represent rational numbers on the number line. These are the integers. Minus 1 is the integer. If we have to represent minus 2, you will represent here. If you have to represent minus 3, here, 2 here, 3 here. And in this manner, we will represent rational number also. I am taking one example of rational number. Suppose you have to represent 3 by 5 on the number line. 3 by 5 is a rational number. So what you will do, I am making it here. Draw a number line. This is a line because it goes endlessly from both sides, and in between I'll mark 0. Now you have to see the number, that this number is proper or what. This is a proper because here denominator is greater than numerator, so its value lies between 0 and 1. When you will divide, this is the divisor and this is dividend here. Now divide, put the point here and write down 5, 6, 30. What is the answer? 0.6. 0.6 or 0.6. It means its value lies between 0 and 1. So I'll make the number line 0 and 1, and between this number will lie. Now whatever the denominator is 5 here, so I will distribute or divide 5 equal points, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now these are the 5 distances, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now 5, divide this much distance into 5 equal parts, because denominator is 5 and the value, this value lie between 0 and 1. Now this is the out of 5 third part. Total parts are 5 and this is the third part. So this is 0 by 5, 1 by 5, 2 by 5, 3 by 5, 4 by 5, and this is 5 by 5. What we have to represent? 3 by 5. So you write here any capital number. Like I have written P. You can write down A, B, C, any number. Alphabet. So you write here P represents 3 by 5. Similarly, if you have to represent minus 3 by 5, on the number line, then the again the 3 by 5 is lying between 0 and 1. So minus 3 by 5 will lie between 0 and minus 1. And now on the number line, we will represent 0 and minus 1 only. This side I'll put arrow sign, this side also I will put arrow sign. No need to show any other number because arrow is showing that here the numbers can be written according to the requirement. Here also you can write any number, positive numbers according to the requirement, but we have to show minus 3 by 5. So I will show because this number is lies between 0 and minus 1. So no requirement to show any other number. Put arrow on the both sides. Now the denominator is 5 again. So I will divide this part into 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. With the scale and pencil, you will write, you have to draw 0 and minus 1. Like you will draw half centimeter this, half, half, half and half. And then write down minus 1. You take this gap half. Again half, half, half and half. And then you write down minus 1. Draw like in this way. Now this is minus 1 by 5. This is 0 by 5. This is minus 1 by 5. This is minus 2 by 5. This is minus 3 by 5. Write here minus 3 by 5. And write any alphabet. Like I have written now Q. You can write any alphabet. Now you write down Q represents minus 3 by 5. See one more example. Suppose you have to draw minus 4 by 3 on the number line. What you will do? First of all, you have to check that this number will lie between which two numbers, which two whole numbers. So first of all, I'll see, regardless of sign, I will check by dividing in the rough copy. I'll check it that it is 1, 1 by 3 and now put the sign. It means this number will come between minus 1 and minus 2. This you will see in your rough copy or in your mind. You see this number lies between which two rational number. So I have told you how to do this. Now this number lies between minus 1 and minus 2. So I draw the number line between, only I will show minus 1 and minus 2 because there is no requirement to show any other number. It will be more easier and more visible to see this number. It means after minus 1, 1 by 3 more. 1 by 3 more after minus 1 by 3. So what is the denominator here? Denominator is 3. So I will divide this part in 3 equal parts. 1, 2 and 3. And when you will draw with pencil and scale in your notebook, you take the distance either half or 1-1. If you will take this one and this 1 centimeter, then write down here minus 1 and here minus 2. Otherwise, you can draw half, half, half. The distances you have to mark or the gap you have to take equal, equal. Now, what I will do, minus after minus 1, this is, what is this point shows, 1 by, this is total is 1 by 3. This is called minus 1, 1 by 3. This is minus 1, 2 by 3. This is minus 1, 3 by 3 means again 1. So it will become minus 2. So this part represent minus 1, 1 by 3. Now I will tell you the another method to show this, because just now we have seen that this number lies between minus 1 and minus 2. So I will draw the numbers till minus 2. and you always keep in mind that this gap and this gap must be equal always. So first of all, I'll draw three equal parts because the denominator is 3, so 3 equal parts, half centimeter, half centimeter, half centimeter, then put minus 1, then again half centimeter, half centimeter, half centimeter, then put minus 2. So divide 0 and minus 1 into 3 equal parts, and minus 1 and minus 2 again into 3 equal parts. Now this part is 0 by 3, this is minus 1 by minus, this is 0 by 3, sorry, this is 0 by 3, this is minus 1 by 3, this is minus 2 by 3, this is minus 3 by 3, then you will cut minus 3 and minus and 3, it will become minus 1. Now it will be minus 4 by 3, this is minus 5 by 3, and this is minus 6 by 3. Minus 6 by 3 means minus 2. But what we have to show here? Minus 4 by 3. So corresponding to this minus 4 by 3, you write here any alphabet, capital. So you write here A represents minus 4 by 3. Now I am taking one more example to make you clear. Represent minus 11 by 4 on the number line. So first of all, you have to see this number lies between which two rational numbers. Regardless of sign, you see 11 by 4 means, convert into mixed fraction, you will get this. But this is minus, so you also put minus sign. So it means this number lies between minus 2 and minus 3. So how you will represent the number line? There are again two ways. Draw the number line, minus 2 and minus 3 will come this side, because on the number line it will, in the negative numbers, will start from this side, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 will come this side. And now how I will divide this distance between, I divide between 4 parts because the denominator is 4 here. So I will divide this part into 4 equal parts, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 4 equal parts. But when you will draw using pencil and scale, I told you just now, you take the gap either 1 centimeter or half centimeter. If you are taking 1 centimeter, then 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter and 1 centimeter. Means 4 centimeter you will take for minus 2 and minus 3. Minus 2 you will start from here, then 4 centimeter. After 4 centimeter you will write minus 3, 1 centimeter gap. The gap must be equal. Now this is minus, after minus 2, 1 by 4, minus 2, 2 by 4, minus 2, 3 by 4. So this represent, here A represents minus 2, 3 by 4. One more method I am explaining you here, how you will do. Minus 11 by 4 will come between minus 2 and minus 3. So I'll draw the numbers minus 1, minus 2 and minus 3, because I know this number lies between minus 2 and minus 3. So I will draw the number line till minus 3, and the gap between 0 and minus 1, minus 1 and minus 2, minus 2 and minus 3 must be equal. And I'll divide each part into 4 equal parts. Now 4 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4. Again here 1, 2, 3 and 4. 1 part, 2 part, 3, 4. Here also 1, 2, 3 and 4. And you have to draw this like half, 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 half. This way, first of all, put the points, then write down the numbers. Now, this is 0 by 4, minus 1 by 4, minus 2 by 4, minus 3 by 4, minus 4 by 4, minus 5 by 4, minus 6 by 4, minus 7 by 4, minus 8 by 4, minus 9 by 4, minus 10 by 4,